Hi, I'm Scott Hanselman. This is Azure Friday. I'm here talking with Chandrika, who works on the Azure portal, and she's going to teach me about hosting plans.
Yes.
So we're in the portal right now, and I'm going to say new website.
Yep.
I can say new lots of different things.
Yep.
I'm going to say creating website. And then over here, we're seeing web hosting plan. Now, I'm familiar with free and basic and standard, but it seems to be a lot more sophisticated now, and I've got a lot more choices. What's going on here? I've got a number of ones that have been kind of auto-named for me.
Yep. So, Scott, the notion of web hosting plan existed always. We actually didn't expose it to you in the former vCurrent management portal.
Okay.
What web hosting plan is really is it's a categorization for pricing and features.
Okay.
So you can put a number of websites in a web hosting plan and get a rich set of features for those websites, as well as get a certain specific pricing tier you want. So what you're looking at here is a set of web hosting plans you previously created in different regions.
Mm.
So you can pick an existing web hosting plan, or you can scroll up and create a new web hosting plan.
Okay. Here we go.
Do you want to do that?
Yeah, so those are the ones that are default, the ones that weren't exposed before.
Exactly.
But now are.
Yeah.
Okay. Oh, wow. Okay, look at this.
So you'll see free, shared, basic, and standard web hosting plans.
Okay.
And you'll see a list of features per card and the price, estimated price, per plan. So you can pick any one of them, or mm-hmm. you can pick from the existing list.
And there's now basic, which is a little bit simpler. So for example, here I can see very clearly that I get custom domains and autoscale.
Exactly right.
Down here I need custom domains. I don't really need autoscale. I can pick that and then see it's $12 cheaper.
Exactly.
Oh, okay, look at that. I can do shared, get custom domains, and then it's only
$7.
So that's very, very clear.
That's right.
So I'll pick, say basic.
Okay.
And then hit OK, and then that new pricing tier can then be picked for other websites if
exactly.
I want to, right?
Exactly right, yep.
So let me ask you this then. If I discard out of here, and let's go look at my websites, because I've got lots of websites.
Okay.
Hansel Minutes is a shared one. And I can click on that. This is my podcast.
Okay.
We can see that I'm not spending much money on it right now. Can
That's
I change
right.
the pricing tier?
You totally can, Scott. Actually, click on pricing tier part.
Okay.
And that does exactly what you did in the create flows.
Okay, so we're back to the same cards.
Exactly right.
And I can see, this one's actually checked. I'm on the light traffic one.
By default, yes.
And that gave me the custom domain because this is my podcast
exactly.
site, hanselminutes.com.
Mm-hmm.
And I can see I get a gig of storage.
Mm-hmm.
Do shared ones, though, they can't be scaled out. I can't have auto scaling and all those features.
Exactly right.
So if I just clicked on, like, say, basic, I could manually scale it.
That's right.
And I hit select. Does that ought? Did I just change the scale? Did I just literally?
You changed the pricing tier for your website,
mm-hmm.
And therefore all other websites that are using the same web hosting plan.
Mm-hmm.
Of course, if you wanted additional features like auto scaling, you want to upgrade to standard.
I see. So
That's
I didn't
right.
actually change the physicality of the website
That's
at this
right.
point.
That's right. Exactly right.
But we can see here, if I scroll back just a little bit more, it's already automatically changed
That's right.
to basic.
Yep.
Now, I'm used to, in the past, everyone else that was near that website kind of inheriting that new plan.
Mm-hmm.
I noticed that this other one, who is in North Central, Ibiza Hanselman, didn't change as well. So I have a little more granularity of control
That's
now.
That's right, yeah. So what web hosting plan is it gives you pricing tier for the region for the set of websites to have the same set of properties, same features, same pricing tier for a given set of websites that belong in that web hosting plan.
Mm-hmm.
So if you, unlike in the past, we give you a little bit more granularity if you're in a different resource group
mm-hmm.
or deployed to a different region.
Oh, okay,
yeah.
That's cool. I like granularity. Because right now, honestly, I've just been throwing everything into West US standard.
Got it.
So if I click on one of these and then look at his pricing tier, there we go. This is one small instance. And basically, I just throw as many web sites as I can
yes.
into there.
Yeah.
And that's an okay thing yep, for me to do?
Yeah, that's an okay thing to do. As long as you're paying for it.
As long as I'm
that's
paying
right.
for it.
Yep.
Now, why do I name pricing tiers and have this notion of pricing tiers as opposed to, like, why did I make a hosting plan?
Why did you give it a name? I guess it's simply to create a sort of a container or a category that you can then move sites to as you so choose, right? It just gives you the ability to remember the name of the web hosting plan as opposed to use our default, which will be something like default one, right?
I see. So now if I go back and say new web hosting plan, I've got one that I named earlier where I said delete this plan.
There you go.
I see. So then I could say, one for my nonprofit or one for my podcast or whatever.
That's right. Exactly right.
There seems to be a theme throughout the new portal where I get to basically name things the way that I want to name them.
Yep, exactly right. We'll give you some defaults, but we give you the ability to name them to make more sense for you, for your applications.
That makes sense. Yep. Cool. We'll dig into more details into how we do web hosting as well as alerts in a video just in a few minutes. It's Azure Friday. Thank you.